You unlock this door with the key of imagination. Beyond it is another dimension. A dimension of sound. A dimension of sight. A dimension of mind. You're moving into a land of both shadow and substance, of things and ideas. You've just crossed over into the Twilight Zone.
There have been three themes, haven't there, running through the conference, which are relevant to what I want to talk about. One is the extraordinary evidence of human creativity in all of the presentations that we've had and in all the people here. Just the variety of it and the range of it. The second is that it's put us in a place where we have no idea what's going to happen in terms of the future. No idea.
And this is the theoretical point, that's the point made by critique. We must recognize that the disasters are not anomalies in the march towards progress. They are fundamental, they are in the very structure of the system, necessary to its survival. If we don't want to make that sacrifice, then we have the political choice to make. Take the Y path the other way. But you can't make that choice if you don't know there's a choice to be made. And so the function of the memorial is critical in the sense that it creates a new category. And in creating that new category, makes it possible to think about that category and then take action. But the taking of the action, if we're talking about a democratic society, can't be imposed.
Actually, what I find is everybody has an interest in education, don't you?
Don't have to answer that question.
I'll answer the question. You want answers?
I think I'm entitled.
You want answers?
I want the truth!
You can't handle the truth!
But the taking of the action, if we're talking about a democratic society, can't be imposed by an elite.
Laura and I send greetings to everyone attending the Abstinence Clearinghouse 2004 conference. We applaud you for helping young people make the healthy and courageous decision to choose abstinence.
You've been my big brother for quite a while now. Could you tell me something in love with me?
Why, sure, Arnold, I always do.
Well, how do you make a baby?
Excuse me, Edna. I don't think we're talking about love here. We're talking about S-E-X in front of the C-H-I-L-D-R-E-N.
I can't.
Nobody will ever find out.
You can trust me.
Just this one.
What is truth? Have you ever really thought about truth?
Choosing abstinence requires character, self-restraint, and self-respect. Through your educational programs, you reach out to countless young people and give them the support they need to make that responsible choice.
Truth can be twisted.
535, there were some local middle schoolers who took a pledge to avoid sex until marriage.
When you value yourself, you rise above the influence. And Cashew says, well, Mr. Thomas, you know...
Motivational speaker Thomas Barksdale and others talk to students at Greensboro's Imani Institute about abstinence. It's part of a program called Above the Influence.
It can be stretched.
A new study claims abstinence education does indeed delay teenagers from having sex. The timing of the results are significant, coming out just as the Obama administration has cut $170 million from funding for abstinence-only programs.
Truth can be skewed.
Why do you want to know?
Can I get a girlfriend?
Well, I think it's time for a Facts of Life talk with Arnold.
It can be stretched.
We are developing best practices for effective abstinence programs.
Truth can be twisted.
The problem is, how do you tell a kid that age about sex?
Very carefully.
Harmless at the time.
Nothing bad could possibly happen.
But are you worried? Are you worried?
Arnold, I think it's time you knew the why and wherefore of sex.
It can be stretched.
It seems.
Just don't leave out the how.
Follow me and learn. Sex ed has begun. Now this square is the man.
Okay.
This circle here, that's the uterus.
That's what it looks like?
Up close, yes. This is lifelike drawing of the uterus. See, the guy takes the car after his job to pick up the uterus at her house.
Mm-hmm.
Because she doesn't work unless she's sweeping up something.
Where did I go?
All the way to a hotel, which definitely has cable. And that's where this trapezoid becomes, shall we say, entangled with the exposed and aerated crotches.
And that does the exposed crotches?
I told you that's the chair and the spatula.
Under it.
Congratulate yourself, my friend. You have just been laid.
Ooh. That feels good.
But Fox News contributor Dr. Mark Siegel calls the findings exciting.
I think it's very exciting to see a study that actually suggests that abstinence may actually lead to a decrease in pregnancy as well as in sexually transmitted diseases.
And reviewing programs across the federal government to ensure we are sending consistent messages to America's teens. Working together, all of us can help send the right messages to our young people and make a real difference in their lives.
There are many voices, feelings, and pressures out there. But the truth, abstinence until marriage is the best choice. Anything else just isn't true. You deserve the truth.
Sex educators of the Planned Parenthood variety, frustrated during the Bush years at seeing their money, really taxpayers' money, go to abstinence groups, cannot just explain these results away. So what do you think? Is this study proof that abstinence education is the best approach to teen sex? Or are these findings, shall we say, unsafe? I'm Anna Con-
We're inside of the emergence of a new apparatus.
I believe our only hope for the future is to adopt a new conception of human ecology, one in which we start to reconstitute our conception of the richness of human capacity. Our education system has mined our minds in the way that we've strip-mined the earth for a particular commodity, and for the future it won't serve us. We have to rethink the fundamental principles on which we're educating our children, nation. We have to be careful now that we use this gift wisely and that we avert some of the scenarios that we've talked about. And the only way we'll do it is by seeing our creative capacities for the richness they are and seeing our children for the hope that they are. And our task is to educate their whole being.